reboot. I'm cold red, my service automated, like data running through my veins. Got you distracted, subconscious overloaded. Careful, don't pull the cord on me.
Ella, I know. You've been talking about how excited you are for the past week.
I know. It's just that back home, we never had Halloween parties. Not many trick-or-treaters either, but this just feels like my first ever real Halloween.
Then what did you do for Halloween, Bella?
Typically, I'd walk through the nearest corn maze. Minus the maze.
Wouldn't that just be a cornfield?
Mm-hmm.
In that case, I think you're overdue on experiencing a proper Halloween. Now let's go.
Kate?
What?
I forgot something.
Bella, we're gonna be late.
Just go on without me and I'll meet you there.
I don't know. The last thing we need is you getting lost.
I'll be fine. I know the party is in the school gym and we walk there every day. Now go!
Alright, I'll see you in a bit.
Stop running and accept your death like a man!
Things never seem to stay dull around here. You're a superior demon. You could take her.
You know better than anyone that I can't beat her. She is a monster. Now please!
What did you do this time?
All I did was drink a wine that she kept hidden in her room.
You drank that. She's been saving that for years. You're right. She actually might kill you.
When I catch you, you're getting a century-long ass-whooping.
Come on, hurry up, man!
Fine, yeah, sure.
Theon, don't you dare!
My bad. I didn't know you needed him, Verena.
How noble of you to die for Judas. If you tell me where he is now, I will make your death quick.
There you are! Hmm? What does that sound? I'm getting a weird feeling of deja vu right about now. Are you all right, sir?
Yeah, I'm better knowing that I got a head start on that beast.
Right. Anyways, would you like me to call you an ambulance?
What human century are we in?
The 20th.
And what country is this?
This would be the US of A.
Hard pass. Besides, no physical wound could ever hurt me.
Hope! I remember you now! You fell in front of Kate and I at the beginning of the school year. Now that I take a closer look at you, aren't you Mr. Erickson as well? I haven't seen you around the school. Do you still work there, or did you get fired?
Well, the thing is...
Are you wearing all that to go to the Halloween party the school is throwing? Now that I think about it, I'm pretty sure you're wearing the same thing when it wasn't Halloween.
Listen, kid. I'm not supposed to be telling you this, but it would take a lot of work to think of some lame excuse, and I'm not the best thinker. Believe it or not, I'm actually not a teacher, but a demon.
A demon?
Yep, the highest ranking demon there is, too.
Mr. Erickson, have you been drinking?
Well, yes, but us superior demons don't get drunk off of human amounts of booze.
Oh, so now you're a superior demon? You seem so creative, Mr. Erickson.
Wait a minute. You don't believe me, do you?
No, I believe that you believe it.
That's not good enough! You need to understand how honored you should be in my presence!
I don't know. I kinda have to get to a Halloween party.
Halloween party? That sounds lame! Trust me, those are nothing special. But hanging out with an epic superior demon like myself is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
I suppose being fashionably late can be okay. Let me just text Kate.
Why is Bella laughing?
Alright, complete and utter stranger who I never met before, besides on one other occasion, and is now half naked claiming to be a superior demon, and seems to have been drinking. Let's go! So you said you're a superior demon, right? Does that mean you can do magic?
Magic is for losers! If you can use magic, that just means you aren't strong enough to punch your problems.
That is the first thing that came out of your mouth that makes a lick of sense.
Ha ha! Glad we're on the same page.
What about possessing people? Is that something you can do?
What do you take me for? A ghost? I would never lower myself to possess a human.
So, what can you do?
Just watch! Boo! What is this?
A mint! Get what smells, mister!
I have an idea.
You know, you don't have to do this.
Shh! I have to show you just how fearsome I can be.
You, a weirdo.
Let us feast on their souls.
I don't get it. Why aren't they scared?
kids these days seem to be numb to a lot of things. I'm pretty sure they're more worried about getting a lot of candy. Also, you aren't that scary, Mr. Erickson.
What? Me? Not scary?
Well, you seem to get scared a lot, so you rub off as rather spineless.
I'm not spineless, and I'm not afraid of anything.
See what I mean, Mr. Erickson? You aren't exactly striking fear into me right now.
But...
Well, if you really want to seem scary, maybe you should ask that lady over there.
I think I just soiled my pants.
Say what now? Whoa!
We need to get the hell out of here!
What about the advice from that scary lady?
The advice won't help if I'm dead!
That lady seemed like she really wanted to hurt us.
She does, and I can't possibly imagine why this random, scary, crazy lady would want to do such a nasty, nasty thing to us.
Hey, what are you two punks doing under Stabbing Bridge?
Yeah, this is our turf. If you want to pass through and not get hurt, give us your candy.
Now listen, lady. I've had one hell of a day.
Oh, Mr. Erickson!
Now give us your candy if you know what's good for you.
All right, I understand completely. Let me get you what's rightfully yours.
What have you done to Sister Nora? Stay back, or the big guy gets it.
If you lay another finger on him, so help me, I will kick your teeth in!
Ah!
Whoa. You beat them up for me?
Well, they did hurt you. Wait, where's your wound?
I did tell you that no physical wound could ever hurt me, right? But with that display of strength, I should offer you a position as one of my demon underlings.
What is that? Like a pyramid scheme?
Of course not! It is an eternal contract!
Yeah, I'm gonna have to pass. Also, I really need to get going to the Halloween party. My friend Kate is probably worried sick!
You still want to go to the Halloween party? Well, I couldn't let you go alone. These streets are too dangerous for that.
I don't know. I think I can handle myself.
Then it's decided. Let's be off.
Well, all right. Looks like the party isn't over yet. Thank goodness.
This place doesn't look that bad. Wait, is that free food?
I mean, I suppose so, but... Oh, well.
Ella, where have you been? I've been calling you nonstop. Did you get lost?
Nah, I just took a detour with Mr. Erickson.
Mr. Erickson? Is he here? Better yet, you were with him outside of campus?
Yeah, he fell from the sky again and then claimed to be a superior demon.
Are you sure he wasn't just drunk?
I don't think he was, but I know he at least was drinking when we met before.
Bella, you know that you should never go anywhere with strangers.
Yeah, I know. I'm sorry.
I'm just glad you're okay. Now, where's Mr. Erickson?
Oh, he's right over there.
That's when I saw one of the students scared and alone and surrounded by like 50 thugs. I took care of them in under a minute because of how awesome I am. I'm probably gonna get some kind of reward for how brave and strong I was.
Whoa. Is that all really true, Mr. Erickson?
Mr. Erickson is so awesome!
Let's just try our best to avoid him.
Well, alright.
Hello to all the ghouls and ghoulettes of Falsetto High.
We are pleased to see so many of you freaks come out for some wicked fun at this year's Halloween bash.
However, as the night is coming to an end, and we all must return to our coffins and crypts, we must first announce the prize costume winners.
The votes have been tallied, and the winner for overall best costume goes to Mr. Erickson! Congrats! Please come up and receive your prize.
I won? I mean, I knew I'd win a prize for my epic heroics! Now, for my acceptance speech.
Huh? No, wait. You don't get any acceptance speech.
I would like to say that this was a long time coming. You know, day in and out, I have felt like the others see me as some kind of musclehead, and that if I'm allowed to do as I please, I might ruin or break things. But I'm here to prove Arena, Theon, Prudence, and the rest of those losers that I really am awesome and the strongest superior demon there is! I even have a tiny human award now that none of them have, so even you feeble humans recognize you're superior!
Thank you for such a creative speech, Mr. Erickson. In any case, we have one more award for tonight.
Right. This year's scariest costume and our new scare queen is none other than our very own Miss Wright.
Huh?
Now let's give it up for this year's costume winners.
I'm going to kill you.
That concludes the Halloween bash. Please make your way to the nearest exit and make sure you don't leave any personal belongings or they will be thrown away.
Nuh-uh.
Ready to go home, Bella?
Yeah, sure. Let me just say bye to Miss Wright and... Hold on. Where did she and Mr. Erickson go?
Don't worry about it, Bella. You can just drop by Miss Wright's office tomorrow.
I suppose you're right. Let's get back then.
And I thought you were going to kill Judas. Are you done already?
I did one better. I told Prudence that Judas has been dying to try their food. I then enchanted his lower body to be incapable of movement, and his mouth to compliment the food whenever he takes a bite.
Oh, that's pretty bad.
I also enchanted his tongue to be 10 times more sensitive.
Oh, you are evil.
Yes. Yes, I am.